सो लेट्स टेक अप द एनालिसिस ऑफ टुडे इज द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर June 24th एंड द फर्स्ट आर्टिकल गोज ऑन टू से दैट बैंक्स गेट असेट वर्थ ₹8,441 करोड़ फ्रॉम ईडी इन्फोर्समेंट डायरेक्टरेट. सो दिस इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द फ्रॉड्स कमिटेड बाई विजय माल्या, नीरव मोदी एंड मेहुल चोकसी. सो इन दिस केस दैट इन्फोर्समेंट डायरेक्टरेट हैज़ transferred asset worth ₹8,441.5 crores to the public sector banks that suffered losses to the tune of 22,585.83 crores. It's 22,000 crores losses against 22,585 crores losses. ED has transferred asset worth ₹8,441.5 crores. Right. So due to this fraud was due to the fraud committed allegedly by the businessman Vijay Mallya, Nirav Modi and Mehul Choksi. So before this 1,357 crore more was recovered by ED, and thus the total recovery has gone on to 9,041.5 crore. So it is amounting to 40%, approximately 40% of the total loss to the bank, which has been recovered till now. So the infographics says that total, like how much asset worth has been seized of all three fraudsters, that is Vijay Mallya, Nirav Modi and Mehul Choksi, and it displays the, like, the asset, that which asset are there, like bank balance is there of Vijay Mallya, flats are there, industrial plot which has been seized, and coffee plantation has been seized, and Kingfisher Tower in Bangalore has been seized. So these all details are there. Like this, you can see the Mehul Choksi's art collection, which is there. It has also all been seized by the enforcement directorate. So this news is with respect to that. Now this another news is Modi to meet Jammu and Kashmir leaders today. This is a follow-up news which we are reading since last 4-5 days. So today is the meeting of Modi with all the leaders of Jammu and Kashmir. Now next news is Chautala to be released from Tihar jail. This Om Prakash Chautala, he was serving a 10-year sentence with respect to it's a teacher recruitment scam. He was jailed with respect to this teacher recruitment scam for 10 years, and he has already served 9 years and 6 months in jail, and he is 86 years old. And so he has been granted 6 months of remission by the Delhi government. So this news is there with respect to the Chautala, Om Prakash Chautala. Now let's move on to another article which says that over 87,000 prosecuted for COVID violations in 3 weeks, government data. So after unlock 3.0, 87,000 persons were prosecuted for violation of COVID-19 norms. So yeah, this is another news that Sisodia Kejriwal hit out at center for rejecting the doorstep ration plan. Okay, so so there is a continuous rift between Delhi government and union government with respect to matters these days, and in one of the matter is the doorstep delivery of ration card. The Delhi government says for doorstep delivery of ration card, which has been denied by a union government. So Arvind Kejriwal, the chief minister of Delhi, has said that fighting with everyone all the time is not right. Fighting with Twitter, Lakshadweep, Mamata Banerjee, Maharashtra, Jharkhand, Delhi government, farmers, traders, even the chief secretary of East Bengal. So he is saying that fighting with all these organs of, like, all of them is not healthy for a growing country. So and but let's see that on what ground center has rejected this home delivery of ration proposal. So the center has said that it was not clear on how Delhi government would maintain uninterrupted delivery in case beneficiary changes their address, or whether the beneficiaries would be allowed to opt out from the doorstep delivery at any point during the year and revert to picking up their ration at the fair price shop. So basically on these grounds, this is one of the ground that the center says that how Delhi government will ensure that uninterrupted delivery of delivery of services to the beneficiaries. And in case the beneficiary want to opt out of the scheme, how it is going to stop, how it is going to handle that situation, right? And the another apprehension by the union government is that how is Delhi government going to ensure that there is a seamless access of delivery of the delivery vehicles would be there in the narrow street area and the high rise apartments, and how it would coordinate the delivery timings if the beneficiary is not at home. And in case that Delhi government says that biometric verification will be done before delivering the goods, so the union government says that how biometric authentication will be ensured at homes in areas without a strong internet connection, right? So these are the two apprehensions. The third is the scheme may also face administrative and operational hurdles in terms of leakage, diversion, accountability issues, and assurance of timely suitability of right quantity and right quality of food grains. So on these three grounds, the union government has rejected this proposal. Let's see what's going to happen, what is going on next. So the next news is that Delhi test positivity rate at 0.15%, which is a very good news for Delhi. And the next news, let's move on. Next news, this is a advertisement. And okay, so Assam two child policy will stall development. Recently, on the June 19th, the CM Hemant Biswas Sarma of Assam had came up with a two child policy. Announced that two child policy will be followed in Assam. So in this respect, NGO named Advocating Reproductive Choices said that there was no evidence to suggest that there was a population explosion in the country. The ARC says that NFHS, National Family Health Survey 5, has for 2019 and 20 has made it clear that men and women want smaller families even without a coercive population policy. So this says that there is no need to have a coercive population policy. People themselves are willing to have a small family, right? So apart from this, TFR total fertility rate in Assam is 1.9, which is far less than the replacement fertility rate, and which is also less than the national average of 2.2. And so what was the actually announcement done by the Hemant Biswas, that barring the tea plantation workers, scheduled caste and scheduled tribe people with more than two children would gradually not be able to avail the benefits under the specific scheme funded by the state. So apart from this plantation worker and SCs and SCs and STs, all the people with more than two children will gradually lose the benefits of the benefits provided by the state. So this was the follow-up move with follow-up like developmental move or in the Assam. Before this, the Assam government has came up with an amendment in the Assam Panchayat Act 1994, which talks about which requires a two-child norm along with the minimum educational qualification and a functional sanitary toilet for contesting the rural poll. So if anybody wants to contest in the rural poll, he must have maximum two child, he must be educated, and there must be a toilet in his house in order to contest for the rural polls. Now let's use this opportunity to read about the total fertility rate. Okay, so TFR, yeah, total fertility rate indicates an average of children expected to be born to a woman during the reproductive age span of 15 to 49 years. So how many children a woman aged 15 to 49 years can produce? This is indicated by total fertility rate. And the replacement fertility, the replacement rate is 2.1. And if the TFR goes below 2.1, then population starts falling, starts declining. So TFR goes below 2 in the so as per the latest NFHS survey, the TFR goes below 2 in both rural and urban areas where girls complete schooling and reduced further as they pass college. So basically the NFHS data says that there is a direct linkage between the educational qualification, education level of girls and the total fertility rate. For example, in Bihar, Bihar has the highest TFR of 3.2, and the reason being it has the maximum illiterate women percentage, that is 26.8% women are illiterate in Bihar, while in the Kerala, where the literacy rate among women is 99.3%, it has the lowest total fertility rate, among the lowest TFR rate, right? So this was there. And apart from this, 77% of currently, like with respect to Assam, this NGO's data says that with respect to Assam, 77% of currently married women and 63% of married men aged 15 to 49 years in Assam want no more children are already, like 77% of the currently married women, 63% of men aged 15 to 49 years in Assam want no more children are already sterilized or have a spouse who is already sterilized. So more than 82% women and 79% men considers the ideal family size to be two or fewer children, right? So basically the article says that there is no need to have a two child policy in Assam, as its TFR is way below replacement TFR. Plus the population of Assam, like majority population of Assam itself, is willing to have a smaller family. So apart from this, there is a five state study, like one of the study by Nirmala Butch, which says that the sex selective and unsafe abortions increased in the states that adopted the two child policy. So those states who adopts the two child policy, in that state the sex selective and unsafe abortions increases, right? So basically there is no need to have a, the article says that there is no need to have a coercive two child policy in Assam. So let's move on to another article, and this is bad news for 11th and 12th students of Himachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh. The Andhra Pradesh has said that AP is going to, like government is going to the Supreme Court, that Andhra Pradesh government is going to conduct the 11th and 12th exams tentatively in the last week of July. So the government has decided to conduct the exam now. So start reading, guys. So now Arunachal Pradesh body files complaint against BRO. So let's use this opportunity to read about this Belt Borders Road Organization. So this BRO is under the control of Ministry of Defense since 2015. The BRO is engaged in road construction to provide connectivity to difficult and inaccessible regions in the border areas of the country. The organization maintains operation in 21 states, one UT, that is in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and the neighboring countries such as Afghanistan, Bhutan, Myanmar and Sri Lanka. So in all these locations BRO is working. So apart from this, apart from the work in India, the BRO has completed construction of Delaram Jiranj Highway in Afghanistan in 2008. Delaram Jiranj Highway is a very ambitious project of India in Afghanistan. The next is the Farkhor and Aini Air Base of Tajikistan were also restored and repaired by the BRO. So now let's move on to another article. The Kashmir Outreach and the Afghanistan. This article is written by Suhasini Haider, and in this article the author is trying to express her opinion about the recent move of central government to meet with the leadership of Jammu and Kashmir. So in this respect, Suhasini Haider writes that at the time of revocation of Article 370, the Union Home Minister and Prime Minister Modi has cited the three agenda with respect to Jammu and Kashmir. The first agenda was to end the terror and violence in the Jammu and Kashmir, and flooding the region with the first, this was the first agenda. The second agenda was the flooding the region with lot of developmental initiative and investment from other parts of the country to bring a lot more investment opportunities and to generate employment and development in the Jammu and Kashmir. This was the second agenda. The third agenda of the government was to occupy the POK and illegally occupied by Pakistan and China. That is POK and Aksai Chin region. And ending the rule of political dynasties in Jammu and Kashmir. But the author goes on to say that it seems very difficult to obtain all these three objectives. Why? Because the incidents of terrorism has already and terrorism violence has no doubt increased since 2019. But this decreased since 2019. But this has been on the cost of massive privation to the people in the name of security, and more than 5,000 people were arrested, and Jammu and Kashmir witnessed the longest internet shutdown in any democracy in the world, and which was instituted for as long as 213 days, and the deployment of troops over there still remains at the peacetime high, right? So the plight of the ordinary Kashmiri battling daily intimidations from security forces and closure of schools and online education for their children and diminishing source of income. So all these are the problems which are being faced by the ordinary Kashmiris over there. So and with respect to the getting the investment opportunities and generating employment over there, the Suhasini Heather says that this attempt to convince investors has been floundered by and large, because there has not been much of investment coming up in Jammu and Kashmir region. So, and with respect to the border situation, that acquisition of Aksai Chin and POK region from the Pakistan Pakistan and China, it seems kind of impossible as of now, because Chinese aggression to LSE since April 2020 has already been increasing, and there was a recent report in which it was reported that China is building up its army near the border regions Jammu and Kashmir border regions. So acquisition of Aksai Chin seems to be the vision of acquiring Aksai Chin region seems to be blurred as of now. So and even the United States is unlikely to counter, and even the US is unlikely to support India in this maneuver of POK, that is Pakistan occupied Kashmir now. Why? Because of its adventure in the Afghanistan region, and now its plight being faced, plight of USA being faced in Afghanistan, and its desperate exit. So all these things coming together, now author is saying that it's very difficult to assume that US is going to support India in case of any two-front war coming up in Jammu and Kashmir region with China, India, involving India, China and Pakistan. So apart from this, the Jammu and Kashmir dispute has been discussed. So it is saying, the author is saying that India has always cited that the Jammu and Kashmir issue is its internal matter. However, the Jammu and Kashmir issue has been discussed on so many international platforms. The Jammu and Kashmir dispute has been discussed at least three times at UN Security Council in after 2019, which had not touched the issue since 1971. So all these factors taking together, the author is saying that it's the path of development in Jammu and Kashmir seems to be very gloomy. Now let's move on to look at another article, that BJP got 76% donations by Electoral Trust. This is said by ADR. Indian Air Force, the ECI shows partiality to ruling party. One of the plea in Supreme Court is said that Election Commission of India shows partiality to ruling party. Now China raising new units near borders. This is what I was talking about, that China raising new units near borders. They are to be used for high altitude warfare surveillance. The units are also being deployed near Pangong Su. So this is the development at India-China border. एंड विथ दिस रिस्पेक्ट जयशंकर फ्लैग्स क्लोज अप जयशंकर इज जयशंकर हैज सेड दैट द इशू देयर इज वेदर चाइना विल लिव अप टू द रिटन कमिटमेंट विच आर मेड अबाउट बोथ कंट्रीज नॉट डिप्लॉइंग अ लार्ज आर्म फोर्सेज एट बॉर्डर एंड द लार्जर इशू रियली वेदर ही whether we can build the relationship on the basis of mutual sensitivity, mutual respect and mutual interest. So this is what the response of India with respect to this deployment of army by China. So now you see a speeding up delimitation process in Jammu and Kashmir. So let's use this opportunity to read about delimitation process. So if you talk about delimitation process, the delimitation literally means the act or process of fixing the limits or boundaries of territorial constituencies in a country to represent changes in the population. So basically it is for the process, it is a process of fixing the limits or boundaries of constituencies for the sake of like number of seats in the Lok Sabha as well as in the state assembly elections. So how delimitation is carried out? So under Article 82, the Parliament enacts the Delimitation Act after every census. And under Article 170, a state also gets divided into territorial constituencies as per the Delimitation Act after every census. Other act, once the act is enforced, the Union Government set up a Delimitation Commission. Now, the first Delimitation Commission exercise was carried out by the President with the help of Election Commission in 1950-51. So, this was the first delimitation which was exercised. The Delimitation Commission Act was enacted in 1952. And Delimitation Commission has set up the has been set up four times till now. That is 1952, 63, 73 and 2002. Under the Act of 52, 62, 72 and 2002. So there was no delimitation after 81 and 91 census. So this is talking about the national level delimitation. But yeah, state level delimitation has been done in between as well. So now let's talk about Delimitation Commission. So Delimitation Commission is appointed by the President of India and it works in collaboration with Election Commission of India. And its composition is retired Supreme Court judge is there and the Chief Election Commissioner is there and respective state election commissioners are also there in the commission. So what are the functions of Delimitation Commission? The function is to determine the number and boundaries of constituencies to make population of all constituencies nearly equal. So basically the purpose is to delimit and the allocate the number of constituencies in a equitable manner and to identify seats reserved for SCs and STs whenever their population is relatively large. So this is the two functions of Delimitation Commission. Apart from this, in case of difference of opinion, the majority will prevail. And the orders of Delimitation Commission has a force of law and it cannot be called in question before any court. So this was all about Delimitation Commission. So recently Delimitation Commission is working in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh region to allot the seats. So now let's move on to another article like Tejaswi blames Nitish for LJP split. Like you must be knowing that Lok Jan Shakti Party of Bihar is witnessing a split. Internal is split. Okay, so 63.2 lakh people get vaccine shots. So yesterday more than 50 lakhs people were vaccinated and now 63.2 lakhs people are vaccinated. So this is a very good development in India. Grey matter loss seen after COVID-19. So this is a study which is being published. This is also still under development stage. That this study says that with respect to the loss of smell and taste, which was witnessed as a like prime symptom of COVID-19 patients, says that the loss of grey matter is there once this symptom is witnessed among the patients of COVID matter. The grey matter which is there in the brain, it started losing out. So this study is still under development. Once it's finalized, we'll discuss about it. Maharashtra monitoring Delta Plus variant case. Ramdev moves Supreme Court against FIR. So this was all. And apart from this, there is a sports news that New Zealand has won the championship. Yeah, before that, state not prudent to reopening as vaccination rates are still low. So this article suggests that state should not reopen, that vaccination is still very low, and center further raises norms for voice over BPOs. High raw material prices threaten survival of MSMEs. Like there is a rise in the raw material prices world over. So industry has urged the government to for making the nil duty on import of steel materials in India, so that MSMEs can be at slightly ease. So apart from that, the another news is household saving fell to 8.3% of GDP in quarter 3 financial 21. So this is RBI data. We said that in quarter 2 the household saving was 10.4%, but in quarter 3 it's 8.2% of GDP. So this is very obvious, as in due to COVID-19 and lockdowns, all the like majority of the household has lost its job, and its impact is clearly visible on the savings. And its household debt to GDP ratio has rose sharply to 37.9% at the end of December 2020 from 37.1% in end of September. So household debt to GDP ratio has also gone up. Now in another development, the CCI probed Google for unfair business practices. CCI means Competition Commission of India, which has probed CCI for unfair trade practices. And the practice which is there of Google is the mandate to pre-install apps. So the court says that the CCI says that this is violation of the norms of competition. So now another news is FMCG locks rise in sales after unlock 2.0. So yeah, this is obvious that food and personal care item will demand for food and FMCG item will go up after the unlock. So yeah, this is what I was talking about, that ICC World Test Championship Final 2021 is won by New Zealand after defeating India. So yeah, this is all about the today's newspaper. Thank you.